That passion going after this long is really the kids.
Who do I play for?
My family, for sure. This group is really motivated. They want to succeed, so you want to be the best coach possible for them, right?
DMV, DC, Maryland, and Virginia, that's home to us.
You know, an era where so much entitlement going on and showcasing myself and my abilities and just trying to make a name for myself. This group really does a great job of understanding, you know, that it's collective. This is Glenn Farello, the head coach of Paul VI basketball. You are now watching the Year of the Panther.
That's excellent. Got my red dress
on tonight. You made great golf. No. Hey, whatever team won you today, get your play.
I think my main philosophy in the program is injury prevention. You know, we have, you know, a lot of physical practices. We play about 30 games. That's a lot of basketball in a short period of time. So the most important thing is making sure that our guys are actually healthy and can make it through the season. For the most part, we spend a lot of time traveling, a lot of time in practice, a lot of time in film. So we don't have, you know, 3-4 hours a week to spend in the weight room. So we try to do a lot of movements, a lot of stretches, a lot of flexibility stuff, a lot of hip work, like within the framework of practice. We kind of mix it into the active warm-up. And that way we can take advantage of the little bit of time that we do have.
In August, I tore my ACL at an AAU tournament. So I've been out for the last 7 to 8 months. Just rehabbing every day, trying to get my legs strong. But just trying to get the range of motion, just get my knee back completely. And throughout the season, I've been trying to bring energy and just somebody like the younger guys, like a big brother. Just look out for them, make sure everything's okay off the court and in school. So yeah, I've been trying to just look out for everybody, make sure everybody's all right.
I'm really proud of Frank, how he's handled himself this year. It's always difficult when you have an ACL injury and you're out for the season, but his attitude has been fantastic. He's been a phenomenal teammate, supporting his teammates, being engaged. You know, we've been able to rehab him through our program as well as what he does on his own in physical therapy, but he's been accountable. You know, I thought he's really handled it mentally very well, I think in a very professional and mature way. So, you know, Franklin Howard is a big part of who we are, and I'm really pleased and happy for Franklin. And it's almost over. He's almost through the journey of it, and he's going to be a better basketball player because of it.
Side, man. We talking X's and O's, all right? If a guy's driving, Kevin is driving, nobody else is rebounding. And then when they get the rebound, four guys behind. Last time, Evan is the only one with the back. Everybody else jogging, and y'all saying, yeah, my bad. Don't tell me that after they score. Man, we said that earlier before the game, man. We're up. We got to establish that. I don't care if they make a run. They're going to score. But as soon as they score, our heads are down. We walk them back. Play the game. The game is not over.
Experience at Paul VI had taught me a lot in terms of life. On and off the floor. We talk a lot of times about giving back. That's one of the key phrases we use here at Paul VI is giving back, you know, share the game. So every opportunity you get here to share your story, you try to share with as many people as possible. So every day we walk in the gym, obviously it's all about getting better, getting the kids better, putting them in situations to be successful. Experience has been great here from the teachers, the administrators, the coaches, the kids themselves, you know, working with great kids, them giving you opportunity to show them things that you learned that you can instill in them so they don't make, you know, similar mistakes that you probably made coming up. So it's taught me a lot. Every day you come in, you get more excited to continue to do what we're doing to get these kids better. Obviously, the goal is to get them a college scholarship. And I think overall we've done a great job of that, and we're going to continue to do that.
January is about the grind. You're going to have your ups and downs. And I thought January was a great learning experience for us. We had a great opportunity to go out to the Bass Pro Tournament Champions to defend our title there. We ended up losing to White Station in the semifinals. Kids got a chance to play on national television, but our kids, I think, learned a lot from that. You know, having just one senior, I was really proud of our effort. We then transitioned and made the long trip from Springfield, Missouri to Springfield, Massachusetts, played against St. Anthony's and won in a game that was a really tough game for us. We were down 9 at one point in the third quarter. We already had a couple players out injured. So we gutted out that victory, and I thought it was one of our better victories of the season because we had to fight so hard as a team. And it was really great, again, a great experience. League play, we've dropped a couple close games. We bounced back from a home loss to O'Connell and got DeMatha next game up on that Sunday and got a road victory. So I was again very proud of the mentality of this group. 5 losses this year on the year, and each of them we bounced back and won the next game and have played really well, cleaned up a lot of the mistakes that we were making. So we're really excited about the stretch drive now. You know, it's an exciting time to be part of Paul the Sixth. And we're excited about senior night coming up here at the end of the season for Evan Taylor. Send them out hopefully in good fashion. And then now we're ready for the playoffs because the whole season's all about building up for that 3 days in February where you get a chance to compete in the WCAC playoffs. The best conference in the country, best tournament in the country. Tired because no one played hard enough. They definitely didn't run the floor hard enough. We would have run better. We would have been filling lanes. If we had the 5, 2, and the 3 at all times, I think we could have scored a lot more. And if nothing else, Marcus, you said something good. Man, you guys are dead. It's a WCC basketball game against DeMatha. It's a 2-point game. It's on senior night. We're trying to win for Evan. Do you forget everything that we talk about, like pregame and all the emotion, and then we just forget about when we're playing? Because I don't see that kind of emotion right now when we're playing out there. Okay? All right, Evan, you're a senior. What would you like to say?
Cut away 11. Take it up to that. We all look dead. Away 11. I'm feeling dead too. I'm going to take it up for y'all. We got another half a point, so it's a good game. 0-0.
We're up 2. Not half a point, but half a goal, right? How about we concentrate on this first 4 minutes? Okay?
Thank you.
The student section is amazing. The sixth man has been, in my opinion, the best student section in our league. It's not even close.
The sixth man, it means a lot to me. It just motivates us. They like they're on the floor. That's why we call them sixth man.
Sixth man, they're great. They're the best student section in the country. And we're proud of that. They get us up for every game, every time. You know, when we're not bringing the energy, then we come out here we for the warm-up. They just give us all type of energy, and we just play hard for them. You know, they come out, support us all the time, so we come out here and play hard every night.
Got every single point to be the championship team. Our goals this season, you know, is just win as many games as possible, max out our potential. You know, that don't necessarily mean win everything. We would like to, but just max out, like, as our potential as individuals and as a team. You know, be the best we can be every day, like, consistently.
Yeah, the season goal for me is to win the championship right now. I mean, we had our lumps in the middle of the season. I think we finished the season out strong and win the championship.
What motivates me to go out and play every day is when I was younger, my father passed away. So he always told me, just do whatever, do give it your best all the time. If you don't give it your best every time, you're not going to know how great you really are. So, I mean, I take that into account every time I go out and play. So I give him my all. I don't care if I'm going out and scoring 20 points, if I score out and score 2 points. So I'm just going to give him my all no matter what happens. If it's not my night, then I'll find a way to get my teammates going, whether it's my energy on defense or if it's just a simple steal to get to a pass, at least to a fast break.
So I appreciate you guys watching, and we'll see you in the playoffs.